Our project is regarding biodegradable films which are produced from soybean by using bacteria such as Bacillus lentis and Bacillus subtilis. Plastic bags have been known to cause a lot of environmental damage. A single plastic bag can take up to 1000 years to decay completely. The more the plastic we use, the greater the chances of environmental damage. All these years we are buying food which is wrapped or packed in plastic material, metal foils, papers, which we generally throw in the garbage bins. Most of these are derived from petroleum derived polymers which are non-renewable and non-biodegradable in nature. Plastic material which is disposed outside is washed away by the water reservoirs, which ultimately causes the water pollution. This finally makes the water useless for the human. Moreover, in the manufacturing of plastic fabrication, many destructive compounds are included in the form of colorant, stabilizers and high enduring substances which are harmful to the human. So plastic should be replaced with other alternative before it's too late. So here we came up with a solution to eradicate the plastic usage by replacing it with edible packaging.
So the main aim of our project is to produce protein based films which are both biodegradable as well as edible using Bacillus lentis and Bacillus subtilis. Our main objective is to first produce protein-based soya films and then perform tests such as biodegradability and antimicrobial activity of the films. With the new advancements in food technology, packaging can be made biodegradable, which are also edible. Edible food packaging improves the quality and appearance of the food. It can also be used as food additives. All we need for this project are soya beans, cheesecloth, Bacillus subtilis and Bacillus lentis, Moringa oleifera leaf powder, which is usually known as drumsticks in India, gelatin, nutrient broth, medium 41 and distilled water. To make the soya pulp, we need to soak the soya beans overnight and then grind it into fine paste. The next step is to ferment the soya pulp. 50 grams of soybean meal is added in 250 ml of medium 41. In two different conical flasks. Now, the media is sterilized by autoclaving it at 121 degrees Celsius with 15 psi pressure for 20 minutes. Once the media attains room temperature, 12.5 ml of each strain were added separately in two different conical flasks. These flasks are now subjected to 1000 rpm in a rotary incubator.
Film preparation. The fermented solution was strained through four layers of cheesecloth to remove small particles. The cheesecloth used was grade 40. The plasticizer gelatin was added in the amounts of 4 grams to the conical flask and solution was heated in between 55 degrees Celsius to 60 degrees Celsius. After obtaining the solution to the room temperature, fine powder of Moringa oleifera, that is 1 gram, is added to each conical flask. This mixture was then cast onto crystal PVC plates of the following measurements or onto Petri plates. Unfermented films were also prepared under the same condition, which acts as a control. These films were then incubated for 24 hours at minus 15 degrees Celsius. Films were then peeled off from the plates and further tests were done. The following pictures show the results of the sheets formed. Picture A shows the peeling off sheets. Picture B shows the soya sheets formed using Bacillus subtilis. Picture C shows sheets formed using Bacillus lentis. And picture D shows the standard control sheet. The other picture shows sheets after storing them for 24 hours at minus 15 degrees Celsius. Further, the replicates of the following sheets was formed for the further tests to be done. Tests to be performed. Biodegradability test. 9 compost pits were made in the ground and the samples were buried. The samples were cut into 3 equal parts for observing on 3 days, 5 days and 10 days respectively. Antimicrobial activity. Foodborne pathogens were placed on dried soya films to test the zone of inhibition. The procedures also used in non-BLS soya films as a control. Mechanical strength. The thickness of the films was measured using a handheld micrometer at 5 random positions of the film specimens. Results: soya sheets made up of gelatin are degraded between 14 to 16 days, which is very less, and compared to plastics it is very harmless. Bacillus lentis showed a broad range of antagonistic spectrum against Listeria monocytogenes, Staphylococcus aureus, Aeromonas hydrophila, Lactobacillus species, Pseudomonas aeruginosa, and Escherichia coli. Bacillus subtilis showed zone of inhibition of E. coli, that is 6 mm, Listeria monocytogenes, that is 2 mm, Staphylococcus aureus 2 mm, and Staphylococcus typhimurium 2 mm. The average thickness of the film was found to be in the range of 0.086 to 0.104 mm.